As you're ready to start a brand new journey of your life, who better to guide us than our Honorable Principal Ma'am, Ms. Neeru Bhaskar. May I request you to address the gathering?
Okay, we meet again now. Good evening, everyone. So can I have all the class 12 to open the camera now, please? If we don't get to see you, how do I address you? Till I don't get to see each one of the beauties out there and the brains out there. Yeah. Now the camera, you know, the screen has come alive. Abhi tak it was like, okay, something is happening, but now the screen looks alive. So to all of you, batch 2021, what to say? I mean, it has been such an unusual batch, I would say. For you, the journey ends in a very unusual manner. The time was unique. The batch was unique. The session was unique. And yes, the COVID itself was so very unique. I will call it unique because, you know what, during this time, we got the chance to witness the capabilities that you had. You were the batch who was actually not physically present in the campus, but was, if I may say so, is by far the most dynamic batch that I ever witnessed. For that, all the teachers in the gallery, kindly unmute yourself and give them a big round of applause. The clap I should be able to hear, then only I'll proceed. I mean, you deserve it, children. You deserve it. Actually, you know what? When this thing hit us, when everything happened online, and I myself got a little jittery here because technicalities are not my forte, I would say. But from there on, you took the baton in your hands, and we could take off. And take off how? We touched the sky we've never touched before. The limits that we surpassed, we've never passed before. And one-to-one, in fact, I saw in the screen where it's written from meetups to Google Meets, very true, you know. From meeting in the campus to meeting you on screen and getting everything done by you was a sheer delight. Because in the process, we also updated ourselves and upgraded ourselves. We knew that still we could strike a balance, and we knew that still we could meet halfway and create a whole, right? Whole as not in H-O-L-E, as in W-H-O-L-E. So I was feeling so, I actually did not want to attend this farewell. I don't want to say goodbye to this batch. And I'm very, very honest when I'm saying this. You can see from my face, my voice. I really don't want to say goodbye to this batch. I wish God had given me one more chance to enjoy the school campus with you all. You know, but that cannot happen, I know. But remember one thing, to those who deserve the best, God always bestows the biggest challenges. So some things, I have written a so-called farewell speech, but then what to do? I was getting so emotional because how to say goodbye to a batch who's still working on projects that is going to take the school a notch higher? How to say goodbye to that batch who still is, being my face? I mean, the face of the school. When I say my face, please don't take Neeru Bhaskar as an individual, but Neeru Bhaskar as the representative of Delhi Public School, Janakipuram. How to say goodbye to you children? How to say goodbye to the head girl who, whenever I get stuck for words, I give her a call and a message and she gives me the revert, and what a fantabulous revert every time we get.
Yeah. But,
yeah, who spoke that? Who said that? Weba? You? Any which way. Shall I read it out? So long years have gone by in the making of you. In these years, I'm going to cry, I'm telling you. In these years, we have grown together, both you and us. We've battled together. We have fallen together, we have rejoiced together, and we have emerged victorious together. You've always been the subject of our actions, the object of our thoughts, and the complement of our endeavors. it is through you all that we have learned so much, that we have realized our dreams. Yes, you have taught us so much. We thank you for it. It is through you all that we once again experience the joy of school life by being a part of your pranks, by sharing your secrets, and by sharing your jokes. Even if you have not told me the secret, I know many of them. Rest assured, huh? Your days of adolescence, I must admit, were the toughest to deal with. Oh God, look at those faces drawn and standing in my office if I said no to something. We at times might have been a little too harsh with you. I would say, I might have been too harsh with you. But trust me, it was not to hurt you, but to make worthy souls out of you. It is all part of the process. I hope you understand that. Because you know what? I've always time and again said that. I'm very conscious of how I look. I look as in how I look as in person and how I look through my children. Because when you go out there, you're going to say you're the alumni of DPS Janakipuram, and people start searching school, principal, how is she? And when you speak that way, when you conduct yourself that way, they have seen you all. I feel you're going to make me look years younger in the years to come, you know. I still need not reach my age because you make me look young and so smart every time you conduct yourself. And today, as you stand at the other threshold of the institution, that is just life after school, do not look back at what you have not done, but look forward to what you can do in the future and take with you the fond moments you cherished here. You know, many of you joined as young toddlers, and today we give you the world armored with the exclusive Dipsite tag. Go out there and make a difference. Be righteous in your actions, dignified in your ways. Let your words bring happiness to others and your actions bring hope. Hope is what we all need now. Be good to people on your way up. They will hold you up when you tumble down. I think we have heard this and seen this in Facebook somewhere, nah? That always be good to the people on your way up, because when you are coming down, those are the people you're going to meet again. And believe in yourself and you can do what you want to do. And sometime in the future, do come back to tell us the stories that you encounter, that you make, that you will build, that you will create. For in your success lies our life's fulfillment, our achievements. I pray that you acquire the four C's, please do. Be competent, be confident, be committed, that you all are. But above all, be compassionate. That is what I would like to see my children, that you can always lend your hand to somebody in need. Thank you. And this, do not take it as a cliche statement. It is actually every word befits you, children. Thank you for your unique contribution to this school. The past year, this year, and the years that have gone by. I truly thank you for all the love, respect, and care that you gave us. You know, the Teachers Day movie or whatever. I have enjoyed every bit of growing up with you. You growing as young teenagers and I growing older. I think I have more than I could give. I have received more from you all than I could give you all. If I have hurt you, I always do that to my closest people. You know what? My teachers, my support system always knows when I tell them that I hurt the most those people who are closest to me, those whom I love the most. Others don't exist for me. And you know why I've always been hurting you, which means I love you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. So if I, in any which way, have hurt you, please forgive me. Leave all the negative feelings and experience behind and take all the positive ones ahead with you all. Before I end, I would like to share two lines with you. I've read it somewhere. The future lies before you like a hidden mass of snow. Be careful how you tread on it, for every mark will show. Dear children, the other day I was in the principal's meet and two people, principal and vice principals of, ma'am, you know what, we always keep talking that if you want to see the pronunciation of Janakipuram, you see that. And they also said, what voice do these children have? We had come to your school in platform opening or somewhere, and some children might have greeted them in the lobby, and they said, the way they were speaking and the way they were hands behind standing and all postures and all ladies and all handsome, I felt so proud. I can't even share with you what I felt at that time. This batch will be closest to my heart. I know I say that, but I've never said this line. Remember this. I might have said I love you all. I might have said I'll miss you all, but I've never said this. But I say it now. This batch has been the closest to my heart because you did what we all together could not do. You did us proud every inch of the way. You made me feel proud. You made me feel like a mom. Mom, maybe not biological children, but I've got so many children right from Kalyanpur days, but this batch holds special to me. I miss you so much. I can't say I'm actually on the verge of tears, children. I can't say that, but I'll really miss you. I'll really miss you. I really can't say, but a special thank you to all the members of the student council, my head girl, my head boy, and all my children of class 12, batch 2021. You actually supported me like children support their old growing parents. You've supported me, you've stood by me, you've held my hand. You've always be my spokesperson. You've been my reflection, and that's what I want to see every time I remember you. I miss not taking group photograph, but that shall await and that will happen, because I promise you today, as and when the situation permits and as and when you're back from your colleges during vacation time, and I'm told by the children that it's always December, we'll have a very, very special meet and greet, and then we can have all the cherished photographs, because I'm dying to be standing amongst all the beautiful ladies out there and all my boys. Thank you so much for making me complete. You make me the principal that I am, not because I've got the appointment letter, but actually you make me feel like a principal, and no thank you can justify that emotion which I'm feeling. I really love you all. I really love you all. Thank you, children, for being a part of my life. Thank you. Dear children, dear batch 2020-21, here is a small prayer for you. Can we all close our eyes for 1 minute and join a hand? I'll say this prayer on behalf of everybody here, and I'll offer it to the Almighty above. Dear God, these are our children. We pray to you to watch over them every time they take a step. We pray to you to bless them every time they are about to make a decision. We pray to you to shower your constant blessings on them whenever they are moving on their trajectory of life. And with that, amen to all. Thank you so much, children. Thank you for being the part of our lives. Thank you.